Good morning. This is our daily tarot. As you can see, I'm in my normal environment now, which is a good thing. Although I went to the city over this last week to do some work, and when I was driving home last night, I drive through a lot of canyons to get to where I live, and there's been mudslides all last year with some big rains that we had and with all the drought that we had the year before. And so boulders will fall in the middle of the road, and sometimes they're really big boulders, and sometimes they look like small boulders. And I came upon this like 4x4 inch boulder, you know, a smaller size one. And I thought I could drive over it, and I caught it on my car, and it did some damage to the underside of my car. So now all the work that I did in the city gets to go toward my car, which is super frustrating. Alas, these are the toils of our life, frustrating as it can be. Ugh. So anyway, let's get into today's cards. The opening card that we have for today is the Two of Pentacles. So we see this person who's walking on a tightrope. There's this swelling water happening behind them. And they have these two coins, one in either hand, and there's almost like a belt that's going around them. And the Two of Pentacles is this reflection around where we put our energy and what we value. So being that there's these two pentacles, if we have one solid coin, which coincidentally enough shows up later in the reading, we have one place to put our attention. But when we have two, if they aren't equally weighted, they can kind of disrupt our balance. And if you've ever tried to walk on a tightrope like this person is doing, it can be really tricky. You can't look down. You can't look to the right or the left, because anywhere that you look is going to be pulling you away from this focal point in front of you. So how do we balance in the midst of chaos, and where do we put our sense of value? This is important to consider today. The challenge that we're facing today is the Page of Wands. So this card is also, ironically enough, looking at our values and looking at our connection to something higher in life. This showed up in a situation when my nephew was in the hospital, and it reminds us to look at our spiritual faith and to connect to the source, to bring down what we need as far as guidance in that situation. Now, consider that the Page of Wands is associated with the sign of Sagittarius, and Sagittarius is the sign of the seeker, that person who's looking towards something higher. So if we feel like we're kind of in this place of balancing our value system, and we feel a little bit knocked off our own balance, this is reminding us to really look to a higher level as in regard to like what we actually value and what we're seeking in life. Now, interestingly enough, the way that we get through this card of the Ace of Wands is, or not the Ace of Wands, the Page of Wands is the Ace of Pentacles. So it's interesting to me that we drop down from two pentacles to one pentacle. And that is that's telling of this energetic of kind of letting the things drop away that are taking you off balance, so that you can actually really focus on that one pentacle, that one coin, that one thing that you really need to focus on today. You know, and how can we let what isn't useful drop away so that we can put all of our attention to that one coin? Because consider that pentacles represent our values and our resources and our belief system, you know? So if we can see how perhaps someone else's belief system has knocked us off our own footing, it brings us back to ourselves. And consider that an Ace of Pentacles is an opportunity. It's like if someone were to give you a big coin, and can you receive it? Can you receive this opportunity? And what do you do with it, right? Because in the background of this coin is this path that leads up this mountain. And so it brings us to this place of, you know, once we can bring balance back into our lives, we really have the ability to put our energy towards this opportunity that's showing up for us. Now, the overall outcome for the day is the Two of Wands. Now, I think this is interesting when we have a Two of Pentacles, a Two of Wands, an Ace of Pentacles, and a Page of Wands, right? We have lots of wands and lots of pentacles coming in today, which is all about how we engage our will to go after things that we value and what in our belief system is engaging us to move forward towards things. Now, in this Two of Wands card, we have this person who's looking out across the land, almost in a sense of dominion, like looking out and what they want to do and what they want to achieve. And they have their staff and they have their direction and they have their will. But then behind them is this second wand, which is bolted to the wall. So it's telling of, you know, this dualistic energetic within us. Like, we want to go out into the world, but there's something that's kind of tethered behind us, which is reminding us that there are things that we need to take care of. There are goals we need to set. We have to be disciplined with our energy and with our resources. And once we can take care of these things that are kind of on our to-do list, that's when we will have I want to say word freedom, but, you know, really it's like the motivation and the energy to move forward towards what we want to explore and be part of out in the world. But we have to take care of this thing that's behind us. We have to take care of our to-do list. So it's Monday, right? It's the beginning of the week. And consider how much of you feels a little out of balance today and what isn't yours to hold on to. So what can you let drop away so that you can really take the opportunity that is present in this week and in your life? We're going to have to take care of some things before we can actually move forward in that direction. So what can you put yourself to task with today? Just to get it off the list. The first easiest thing to get off your list, do that. Even if it's laundry, even if it's watering your plants, you know, take care of some simple practical things so that you have the energy and the force to move in the direction that you want to. I send you a good wish today and so much love on this Hallmark holiday of Valentine's Day that we have. I encourage you to do something nice for yourself today and give yourself a little love, because the world needs it and we can't always get it from other people. So we need to have a daily practice of giving it to ourselves. Mwah. Sending a good wish to you.